Yeah, I went missing. Everything was a disaster. The police were involved. Everyone was very, very concerned. I was just in breaks. Apparently 3 hours is a bit long to be choosing a cake. I disagree. But the police didn't find me for quite a long time. And I figured out why this was. It's because the police report, you know, of my identity put out by my boyfriend wasn't the best. You know, he got most of it right, fair play. You know, ethnicity, Caucasian, eyes blue, hair blonde, body type, cut to me with a great personality. So, he's dead now. Late that night, I squashed him with my great personality. Also, last week I was a doctor. You know, I went through years of training, you know, and I got there. It was my first day, and I was so excited, and I got sacked on my first day. Sacked on my first patient, actually. And I don't know what happened, because this guy came in, I asked him all the questions I'm supposed to ask. I said, do you drink? He said, no, I don't drink. I said, oh, do you smoke? He said, no, I don't smoke. Said, oh, have you any drug use? No, don't do drugs. Oh, what about, any unprotected sex you've had recently? He said, no unprotected sex. So he's dead now. Apparently my diagnosis of boring as fuck wasn't quite correct. Hello, everyone. I hope you're enjoying Freshers Week. Excellent. This we mentioned before, this is a very inclusive university. You know, I'm sure you're very accepting and tolerant, which is very important when you come to university, particularly this university, because it's lovely. Especially with kind of sexualities, the world is kind of, you know, constantly adapting to the sexualities, and great, it's evolving, everyone's being lovely. We know about gays and lesbians, we know that, the world's kind of accepted that now as a thing, and that's great. But there's a lot of other sexualities that are you know, equally important. There's anyone here asexual? But asexuality, in my opinion, is kind of like, you know, I'm fine with asexuals, but my attitude towards asexuals is sort of like my attitude towards people who don't like chocolate. It's fine, it's just more for me. And any demisexuals in the room? Lovely. Now, if you don't know, demisexuals are people who like to feel the, you know, the romantic connection. They like to get a strong connection with someone before they have sex, which, again, perfectly fine. I often find that a strong connection can ruin the sex. You know, you're going at it, he's going, oh, I really love you. That's great, darling, but is it the best thing you could be doing with your mouth? So I went into Boots the other day. I've got one of these free condom cards. It's great, you know, if you're a student, you get free condom cards. You can go get free condoms from any pharmacy, it's brilliant. And I went into Boots the other day, and I went, oh, can I get some condoms, please? And the guy said, oh, yeah, no, we don't have any. So I all know what you freshers have been up to now, so thanks to you, I'm now condomless. I'm pregnant later this week, I blame it on you. But that shows the, you know, the division. I'm a third year now, I've just gone into third year, and it really shows the division between freshers and third year. You know, freshers, you're all going wild, oh, yeah, let's have sex with everyone, let's grab, oh, I don't know, Nutella on each other, I brought different shoes and a little bag to and also brought all your hopes and dreams. If we get four in a month over the weekend. Because I've been in a relationship a long time, it's about a year and a half, and it changes. You know, the dynamic very much changes. Nowadays, it's more like, you know, everything's getting a bit, oh my God, do you want it? Yeah, I want it. Do you need it? Oh my God, yeah, fuck, I fucking need it. So, should we start? Yeah. What was the Netflix password again? Yes, I do have a boyfriend. Been with him for quite a while now, about a year and a half. Met him at this uni. Yeah, it's lovely. For those of you who haven't noticed, I've got some breasts.
Stage in my life where I can say that one of my friends is pregnant. That's weird.
I don't care for that very much. But she's pregnant, and of course, we're all so proud of her. She's the first one in our friendship group to get pregnant. She's a little bit older than me, and we're all proud. I was having coffee with her recently, and I was like, you know, how's it going? And she said, oh, it's going really well. I'm loving being pregnant, but I'm really not looking forward to the birth. And I was like, ah, the pain. She was like, no, it's not the pain. I was like, what is it? She was like, of course I'm looking forward to being a mum and all this stuff, but she was like, I've got a little game going at the moment. I'm really having fun with it, and when I give birth, I won't be able to do it anymore. I'm like, what are you on about? Basically, this is what she's been doing. Whenever she goes into a shop, very, very pregnant, buys clothes, and they say, do you want to get the hammer? She just clutches her bum and looks at them in horror. The people who got that, thank you, are very dark minds.
Because me and that old lady both know there's nothing better than a night in with some porn and your two fingers.